In this lesson, I'm going to share with you the four most important aspects of technique for beginner guitar players. They are posture, how to hold the guitar, your fretting hand, how to hold the strings down and create clean notes, your picking hand, how to hold a pick and address the strings, and last, but certainly not least, overall tension management. Now, this lesson is probably the most important lesson you're ever going to have because of two distinct reasons. This is going to make playing the guitar physically easier, and it's going to prevent you from being injured while playing the guitar. And for each of these aspects of technique, I'm going to give you some check-in points to make sure that you're doing it correctly. Because even, I mean, I've been playing guitar for a while, I still kind of am at fault in some of these areas, and I still check in as I'm playing to make sure I'm doing it as good as I can. This is just one lesson in a series where I'll take you from zero to guitar player in 30 days by teaching you the four super fun skills that'll get you hooked on guitar. Before you get started, you'll need to download the tabs, course guide, and 30-day checklist. To get yours, just click on the link in the video or visit 30daystoplay.com. So let's start with posture. There are three important aspects of posture. And first, let's focus on the guitar itself. How do you hold the thing? Well, I want you to take the waist, this indent in the bottom, and place it on your right leg if you're a righty, your left leg if you're a lefty. I want you to keep it parallel to the ground and straight up and down. I don't want you to be angling it this way, and I don't want you to be angling it that way, straight up and down. And I say this because it'll actually influence other aspects of your proper posture, or the proper posture that we're striving for. Now, I will say this in terms of holding the guitar straight up and down. There are going to be times when you're going to want to look at the strings, make sure your pick's hitting the right string. That's okay as long as you check in and then return it to its proper sitting place. Okay, so that's very important to keep in mind. It's okay to look, it's okay to move, but remember, while you're playing, you want to keep it straight up and down. The next thing that I want you to be aware of is your back. Okay, so we've got the guitar. Now we're going to move on to your back. I want you to almost act like your Tim the Tool Man Taylor's neighbor. You know, Wilson, when he was peering over the fence to talk to Tim. If you've never seen that show, it's okay. Just imagine like you're looking over a fence. That's the kind of lift I want you to have in your back. I don't want you to feel heavy in your back, right? I don't want you to be rounded. I want you to be nice and straight up and down, like almost as if your back is a string and somebody's pulling you up. Okay. The last and final check-in point for your posture is going to be your shoulders. Okay. I don't want you to hold tension in your shoulders. I want your shoulders to be nice and relaxed, not necessarily back, but just nice and relaxed. If you find yourself crunching or hunching or kind of lifting your shoulders, that's a bad thing. Let your shoulders drop and have that back be nice and straight. So you got the guitar straight up and down, your back like a string, and your shoulders nice and relaxed and dropped away from your ears. Now let's move on to your fretting hand. This one's extremely important because this is gonna help influence how your notes sound on the guitar. So when you fret, it doesn't matter which finger you fret with, whether it be your index, middle, ring, or pinky, I want you to fret on the very tip of your finger in the sweet spot. So I'm gonna use the second fret of the D string here as my example. So I want you to be right on that fingertip, and I want you to have your finger where you're fretting the string right next to your intended fret. Okay? If you're too far behind the fret, you're gonna get some buzzing. It's gonna sound a little wonky. And if you're on top of the fret, it's gonna sound fuzzy or muted. You don't want either of those things. You don't want a buzzy note, you don't want a fuzzy note. You want a nice clean note. So be right next to the fret and on your fingertip. Now the other thing to keep in mind with your fretting hand is I want you to have proper arch in your fretting fingers, whether you're using just a single finger for a single note or a full chord, okay? And how you achieve this is by number one, fretting on your fingertip, but number two, keeping your fretting palm close to the bottom edge of the guitar neck. Okay, here's what happens when you keep it further away. See how flat my finger is? You don't want a flat finger. You want a nice arched finger. And again, to do that, just bring your palm closer to the bottom edge of the fretboard. That'll introduce the proper arch you need to get in the perfect fretting position. So again, fret in the sweet spot and have good arch or arc in your fingers. Next, let's focus on your picking hand. Now, one of the questions that everybody asks when they're first starting, I asked it, you're probably asking it as well, is how do you hold a pick? Well, I want you to pretend like you're holding a TV remote, right? You're about to watch, well, Tim the Tool Man Taylor, or The Simpsons, or your favorite show. I want you to place the pick right on the front part of your index finger, kind of on that first section, right after that first and farthest knuckle from your main knuckle, right here. And then I want you to go ahead and secure your thumb on top of it, much like you're pressing the button on the remote control. Make sure the pick point is perpendicular to your thumb, and there you have it. That's how you hold a pick properly. Now that you're holding the pick properly, I want you to address the strings properly, right? And a lot of times there's this feeling like you have to thwap the strings or just kind of take this running lunge at the strings. That's not true. In fact, picking should be of a very minimal effort. So essentially what I want you to do is rest the pick, and I'm going to use the open D string here for my example. Rest the pick on the string and then let the weight of your hand follow it through the string, right? And I want you to feel like you're plucking or pulling away from the strings. I want you to let the weight of your hand make the pick follow through the string, right? So it's resting and then it releases. The last and final thing that I want to focus on in terms of technique is tension management. And if you maintain proper posture, this is going to help big time. But overall, what I want you to know is that tension creates injury. Tension creates buzzy chords. Tension creates fuzzy notes. Tension is all bad. I want you to be as relaxed as possible. Now, I know when you're trying something that's difficult or you're trying something new for the first time, there's this tendency to kind of tense up. I want you to fight that as much as possible. You're never going to get it perfect right off the bat, but once you're aware of it, you can ease up that tension. And common tension areas are your jaw, right? You can clench your teeth and kind of grit your whole face and make kind of that guitar face. Or you can hunch your shoulders, which we already talked about in the posture. Or you can feel like you're white-knuckling the pick or white-knuckling the strings while you're fretting them. If you feel yourself doing that, take a second, recheck in with your posture, check the guitar, check your back, check your shoulders, take a breath, and then try again. I can assure you that if you keep these four essential technique tips in mind, guitar playing is going to come much easier and much more pain-free, which is awesome and what we all need. This is just one lesson in a series where I'll take you from zero to guitar player in 30 days by teaching you the four super fun skills that'll get you hooked on guitar. Before you get started, you'll need to download the Tabs, Course Guide, and 30-Day Checklist. To get yours, just click on the link in the description or visit 30daystoplay.com.